Welcome to my channel. Today has been make in particular duration. Also, they wanted to know the total sales in a year and month and division. So they wanted to check like that. Also, wanted to check that how this visual allow you to check the month wise sale, how much amount they made a sale, and also they wanted to switch this like sometime this you wanted to total number of work order has been sent, and sometimes they wanted to see how total sales by month. So for this option they can check it out, see this automatically, then they change it, same value, same everything, but changing that label just because the given the criteria. So how to create this kind of dashboard, and like suppose I wanted to check the countries detail, how much country made a sale, so you can also control that. This is very important and very good dashboard that client requested to prepare that. So if you wanted to create this kind of dashboard, so let's begin with the dashboard. So for this, here I have a Power BI desktop. Now let me create a copy on this. So let me remove the or everything which I prepared. So Control P and remove the main arrow key. Then come to the manager dashboard. Click on manager dashboard. It's slow. And now reached successfully in this. But I created the copy to avoid before. Then we can start building from initial level. Slicer, hope you're aware about slicer, that you can easily add that, but I can show you one how to add that. So let's start with the preparing dashboard. So first I wanted to change this to black color. So page setup, you can change your required color. Does that mean that follow my color? If you feel that you wanted to change more colors, yes you can. And maybe you wanted to give the blue background, yellow, red, whatever it suits you, you can give it to them, no problem. Let's talk about the category setting first. So for this, you need to, we don't have such kind of category in here. See this, in digit tab, we don't have the anything here. So for this, how to connect that? Then they wanted to see total sales, and again also they wanted to see the total number count of work order. I know that you can create that, but how to give the filter, that's the biggest part in that. So what I did, I created the table here. You either can create from here. So what I need to do, you can just enter data and give the column name, test, whatever name I wanted to give. I already created that. Return the sales total, then I want total sales. Here I want total orders, and just leave it. Did this one? Yes, you can do it here. You can add left, right, more columns, and give the name and click OK. Since I already did it, so let me show you. Say this. Same way, I prepare the category table, and it has the two values, total sales and total order. Before going to show everything, I can just show you the measures. What I major create, what all major created. First employee name. Obviously, we wanted to do the last employee. If you wanted to see that, let me increase the font. If you could press control and plus press together, the formula bar size to be increased, font size to be increased. So now I want to do make sale employee sales. So wildcat calculated total sales filter by employee is not equal to blank. If you select, also you can give select values. Select values if not equal to blank. So return, give the pass the variable. Next, call the reason. I want you to distinct the reason here. Distinct, so do not have a reasonable cells. I didn't create any slicer. Let's slicer here. Definitely, if you want to give the dynamic dynamic header, so means dynamic title of the visual, so you can select that. You can pass the value here. In my past video already it has. So if you want to check my past video, I'll give the link below video. You can find it out. But let me explain. I wanted to see total cells against the selected value. So whatever value selects, that value pass to the title. And same thing, same like switch level. That I'm exactly looking for. Here, suppose I given the criteria that if selected value is equal to total cells in slicer, then total cells to be displayed. Total cells is a variable, not a variable, total cells is a measure that creates sum of order total. So that I given them. So I want to do total cells, else selected value category table total order. Then count of order IDs. So you can select the count of order ID. Else, if selected value is blank, then display the by default is total value. So this way you can do it. So now if I pass this formula, so whenever I'm going to check it out that what all the value pass, you can check here automatically. So let me add the table here to show you. Okay, now let me select that. So the major switch level. Oh, switch level. And against month. Month name. See this total cells again level, and if I wanted to change this by criteria, so see this, what is it display? See this. I know that you're not able to see that. Let me change the font size of the slicer. That it will display. Change it to the black. I know it doesn't see here, but because color is different, that reason. See this. Now, if I select the reason, it doesn't work, seems. It doesn't impact much. But if I select the country, 100% impact that. So this count is going to change. So it's a totally dependent requirement. And now if you switch to the category, say this total order. And if I were to switch the total cells, then say this also total cells to be displayed. So if I change, I wanted to change the shift month and year number so that I can get it properly, proper information. So now let me use the cluster charting and see this cluster charting. Also you can use this one as whatever is suits for you. So I wanted to give the month name level. So let's I don't want to use this one. I wanted to use this is best for it. Next part is that create the small table. Formatting will do it later on, no problem. Let's create the table. So go to the table, and here we wanted to see total cells by. So this manager tab it has job title against total cells. So for this, select the job title. Against total cells. Now I would like to format it so that it can display to be changed. Title change to job title. title. And total sales is perfect. Let's move to the color part. I wanted to change the header. White color and background to be a different color, give it to them, no problem. Whatever color you choose, you can give it to them. Next, come to the size. You obviously increase the font size a little bit so that display can be much better. Next is go to the value. Also, you can change value. Font color is white, background color is. Pass the two color here, so it will give the blue for one and alternate font color is white, background color is different red. Now the value change, and let's change the total color too. So the total I want you to display like the display like font color is white, background color is red. So now I change that successfully, and I don't want to see the background color, so let's remove that so that display can be much better. Let me settle it out properly. Client wanted to know that next client wanted to know the job titles to filter criteria required for the job title. So how to control that? So for this we have a chartlet slicer in add option, and you can download from, you can install the visual from this Chiclet slicer 1.6. you can download from the, go to the get more visuals, and there you can import and just click add option and get this. Now I want to do a Chiclet slicer here, and I want to get the job title. Just you need to format it. I want that number item to be only 3 is not required. Now perfect. If you wanted to see the horizontal, yes you can, and vertical, yes you can, as it is. Next, in place or out place, depend on you. If you want to give header, yes you can. So let's give header. Something else. Drop title. Font color is white. Background color is red as usual. And next, change the chiclet color. Select color this, over is this, and unselected is leave as it is. Unselected is display like this too, or maybe change it. Let's change that. And now we can adjust here. Give the bit space, little bit, so this looks can be better. Let me adjust that. Yes, perfect. Now I don't want to give the background color, so just close it, the background color, nothing else. For here, you can just close the background color. On the data label, if you wanted to give the title, yes, you can. And background color to be closed. And change it to the all value as it x axis. Font color to be white. Text size, if you want to register, yes, you can. Title is not required, no more required. Let's come to the y axis. Font color to be white, and sorry, background color we have already. Title, I don't know how to display, so remove the title. Let's come to the directly come to the title. So title, definitely if you wanted to give the font color is white, and background color is usual color. So it is this one. Now next, I wanted to change the font size little bit of the value so that we can cover up. So I wanted to change as it is. Value to be 12. Yes, perfect. Now adjust that. Also, you can change 0.11. And 10. 10 is too small, so 11 is perfect. Now, this one we have done, and let's add this value. So, number of order by city. So, we need to add the cluster chart here. Chart is up here. City. So we need shift city and order total. Count of order ID. Not releasing the value. As a count, number of order. Now format it. See this. So you can add one by one. This and just change the background color. And see this background will change, and now change the title. So access, come to the access, change to font color is white. Y axis, change to the font color white. And now see this values display. Also you can change the title to just change the title color, because yes, perfect. Now change it, font color is white, background color we have already. So if you wanted to give any specific color, yes you can. So let's get this color. So see this, now we have everything in place. See this. series. This way you can prepare the dashboard, and even if you wanted to filter, so if you have any doubt, any questions, just put the comment in the below of the video. That is really appreciated. And if you like this dashboard and the way which I created the videos, please don't forget to subscribe my channel. And also the quick information that you will be able to download this PBX by below link download option. Thank you so much for watching my video. Bye bye.